Dear students, in this lecture, we will try to understand about the structure of DNA. The structure of DNA is an important question there from the examination point of view, as usually it will be asked in a 7 marks or in a 10 mark question. The structure of DNA is also referred sometimes as a salient features of the DNA molecule or three-dimensional structure of the DNA molecule. So the structure of DNA was first elucidated by Watson and Crick in the year 1953, and he has proposed this thing as a molecular model of DNA. He has elucidated this thing based on the X-ray diffraction data that was collected by Maurice and Wilkins. And however, Watson and Crick are the person who was given a molecular model based on that X-ray diffraction data, which explains best about the physical, chemical and biological properties of the DNA. So for this contribution only he has been awarded there a Nobel Prize in the year 1962. And this is again an important milestone there in the molecular biology. Since after understanding about the structure of DNA only, a lot of other advanced studies have been started there in the field of molecular biology. So the following are the points that have been proposed as per the model. I will try to list you the points. You can check this point with an image. Say, this image is the one that have been given there at the downside. So, if you go to the downside, you can able to see a image there. In this image, whatever points I am narrating are all has been very clearly depicted. Each DNA molecule consists of two helical polynucleotide chains or strands that twist around each other to form a double helix. So, first point. The strands will run always anti-parallel, that is, their 3' to 5' phosphodiester bonds that have been located there in the chain will be always in an opposite direction. In each polynucleotide chain, the phosphate molecules and deoxyribose sugars forms the backbone and they lie outside to the helix. However, the nitrogenous bases, that is adenine, guanine, thymine and cytosine, are present inward perpendicular to the helical axis of the DNA molecule. The nitrogenous bases of two strands are linked together by the hydrogen bonds that forms between the oxygen and nitrogen atom of the adjacent bases. Since there is a fixed distance between the two strands, which is approximately of a 10.8 to 11 Armstrong, only some specific bases can be fit into that particular space, that is between the two polynucleotide chain. That central space can be occupied only with certain molecule. Therefore, the base pairing rule becomes a specific and important one here. It is always a purine. A two-ringed molecule will be pairing with pyrimidine, a single-ringed molecule. So, it naturally falls as adenine pairs with the thymine and guanine pairs with cytosine. Number of hydrogen bonds located between an adenine and thymine is always 2, whereas it's 3 between the G and C, that is guanine and cytosine. So, all these points will be again very clearly given in this image. You can look at here. And the other subsequent points are, the two strands are therefore complementary in nature. If A is there, then T will be there in the other strand. If G is present in one strand, only C will be present in the other strand. That is the complementarity. In a DNA molecule, the two complementary chains are twisted around each other and form a double helix around a common axis. So, this is one chain and this is another chain. They twist on each other around a common axis. And the next point is, one turn of helix measures about 34 Armstrong and it will be having 10 nucleotides. So, this is a 34 Armstrong and this particular space occupies maximum of a 10 nucleotides. Therefore, the distance between the adjacent nucleotides will be automatically of a 3.4 Armstrong in length. The diameter of the helix is about 20 Armstrong. The double helix shows a two different kinds of groove, which are referred as a major groove. and minor groove. So these are the two grooves that could be seen there in the DNA molecule. Both these grooves are large enough, which allows certain proteins or enzymes to fit in there, and they are in turn involved in the process of replication and transcription process. Next, we look at the physical characteristics of the DNA molecule. So the molecular weight is about 10 Daltons. Molecular configuration of DNA is three-dimensional in configuration. That is the reason in the beginning itself I told the whole content is related to salient features or three-dimensional structure or structure of the DNA molecule. The diameter is about 20 Armstrong. So you can able to see the diameter, which is of a 20 Armstrong. Diameter of base pair in a strand is 11 Armstrong. The length of the hydrogen bond is 3 Armstrong. Angle of one complete turn of the twist is about 34 Armstrong. Distance between the adjacent nucleotide is a 3.4 Armstrong. As the distance between two complete turn is 34 Armstrong, so automatically the distance between the adjacent nucleotide will be approximately of a 3.4 Armstrong. And we already learned that in one complete helix, it will be 10 base pairs have been present. Further, to understand about the structure of the DNA molecule, you can go in the e-tutorials of the first unit. There I have provided a small video. You can go into that video and you can able to get a still more information about the DNA molecule. That is serial number 8. You just click it here. It will open as a separate video, which again explains the other points are in a very simple and clear way, in which you can able to see a video and the explanation will be again given there in the text that will help you to understand the concept well.